round 4. Fight! Ha! Yeah! Get ready for the next battle. Round 1. Fight! Get ready for the next battle. Round 1. Fight! Round 2. Fight! Yeah! Round three. Fight! Yeah! New challenger. Ogre, Jinpachi Mishima. Get ready for the next battle. Get ready for the next battle. Round one. Fight!
Get ready for the next battle. Ready. Knee dead. In a second,
round
ready
two.
For the battle. You can pick
fight.
Got this combo. Here comes the blast. Smash on your pronto from all directions. The cuffs, homie, you my next win. Get you powered up and come back. Revenge.
Start
checking chins. You won't last a couple seconds. Buster's gone in the wind.
Fight.
And doggy does it again. Then y'all win, doggy. I need that. I'm down. 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 the fist. You about to get smashed on, probably get flicked. Probably get
new challenger. Get ready for the next battle. Round one. Fight! Get ready for the next battle. Round one. Fight!
You
Jutsu. Fight!
Get ready for the next battle. Round one. Fight! Round two. Fight! Get ready for the next battle. Round one. Fight! Fight! challenger. Get ready for the next battle. Round one. Fight! Round two. Fight! Get ready for the next battle. Round one. Fight! Three. Fight! Kimishima. Get ready for the next battle. Round one. Fight! Round two. Fight! Get ready for the next battle. Round one. Fight! Fight! K.O. Final round. Fight!
It's like riding a bike.
Is it?
Yeah, you'll see. Get ready for the next
bat. Wow. Someone called it out. Where's Nina Lars? And then they're like, oh,
shit. What? That guy must be a scrub too. Okay, I know what they're doing.
Yeah, it's like riding bike. Down for one. Every. Oh yeah, fighting against ogre is not like riding a bike.
What the fuck? Oh, unbreakable, right?
Yeah. But yeah, that's pretty tech. No.
Oh god.
That's oh what the hell? Why? This L43 Jinpachi a lot. He can't launch it. Well, okay, yeah. Don't lump his too. He's too tall.
That's not what I wanted.
Yeah. Alright, maybe it's not like riding a bike, but...
Oh, hold on.
Oh, well, that one's just hard to break. Oh, you're fine.
Shit,
you're fine. Wait. Oh, you're fine.
This is infinite nowadays.
Oh, the gimmicks! He knows you don't know.
Alright. It's time to play tournament style.
Well, throwing against Ogre is good because he can't see as well as you can see. Maybe slightly better. The gimmicks. You're fine. You're severely hurt,
shit.
But fine.
It's all the way to the other side.
That was a small stage. That side, anyway. Hiro. Slidey. Double X. Yeah, see, you can't watch it. Oh, if you did real combo, you know. That's pretty good. Oh no!
Oh, that's safe?
Yeah, it's just like Julia's. You have to low parry on hit.
Alright. I think I kinda have a feel for what I used to do.
It's only been one game. I would have upward 3'd more against Jinpachi.
Alright, I think I'm giving too much credit.
No, he just can't launch it. Well, he can launch it, he has to do like sidestep God Fist. It's super weird.
You gave me credit?
No, it's just Jinpachi. Jinpachi can't launch it unless you do, I think it's sidestep left God Fist. You block upward 3 from Lars, you do a sidestep left God Fist.
So I'm gonna have to the lightning screw?
Yeah, triggered screw, but yeah.
Wait,
or tell me later. Alright. Just do a lot of upward 3 against Jinpachi. Not against Ogre, he can still launch it. But Jinpachi is probably the character that has the hardest time launching it. Oh, no break. Where's the demon recovery? Oh god. Ivory? One throw. Auto break?
Auto break? Yeah!
With the gimmicks. Oh god. Ah, you're not. You're severely hurt. You're not dead. Up four. Oh. Like 11. And like no range. You're just a little late on it. And that's 13. Careful. He can fly. Oh. Well, that's okay too. Oh, he's dead. Simple.
That one I remember.
Nice and simple.
Dude, fucking remember this.
Oh, he has a really good 13 though. I'd be worried. Oh, that was really good improv. Oh, and you could have killed him. Yeah, that's really dumb. Just get ready to launch if he does it, that's all. Which is easier said than done. That wasn't even a combo. That's pretty good. Oh, why that Ender? You need a tag.
Oh, you're right.
You're lucky Michael sucks at tagging.
There's a tag in this game?
He could have traded tags after that Shining Wizard Ender. That's why he shouldn't have done that. But.
Yeah. See, who might need some training wheels?
It takes a while to get used to. Jinpachi is easier, but Ogre is a little different. You can do Kuma combos.
Thanks for telling me.
Well, I mean, down forward one would be fine. Oh no. That's okay.
How did I end up that way?
Because you try to wake up kick or tag, one or the other.
Oh yeah.
You admit that?
I admit it.
Then it makes sense. Oh god. Yeah, you can punish that. Long legs, or long arms. Well, you better break it if you're Lars, because he gets a full combo.
Right. Fuck,
that's 50-50. Oh, you're dead. That's 50-50. You're alive. Oh no! Oh bitch! Oh no! Naive, because it's a seeable mix-up. Yes. You crash a lot more than you used to. Maybe that's not like riding a bike. You crash more than you used to.
Oh. It's been a while, man. I need like maybe 20 games to.
That should be enough.
Get back to my old self.
Well, I mean, that is just preference, but you used to raw tag way more.
Alright, fine.
I'm just saying you used to. I'm not saying you should. That's subjective. Get ready for the next
best. Are we we're losing viewers.
No.
Oh.
Yeah,
there you go. frame advantage. Up for 3 to hell of him. Oh, well, soon enough. Just brought up an up for 3. See? Ooh, oh, shit. Punch fairy. Punch fairy. Ah. 4-3 and look at. Oh. Yeah, see? Oh no, he was airborne.
Oh.
Oh. I would've just up 4-3 again. That'll take some getting used to. Storm heals. Oh, don't! Floor! That could've been a lot worse. Yeah. He's scared of up 4-3. Oh. Shit, up 4-3.
Alright, some more of that?
Yes. Just base the whole game around that. If you're playing Lars versus Jinpachi, just base the whole game around that. Oh, I was surprised. Oh no. Yes. That'll take some getting used to.
Shit.
Oh. Oh no, you're dead. Yeah, you definitely did.
Damn. New challenge.
Calm down, run around, and throw shit out.
Oh, forget about that one too!
A low? Yeah, you have lows. You got two of them.
Yo, that's one of my 5 moves, come on.
How do you forget your 2 lows?
It's been a while.
Oh, maybe now you'll back two things.
Oh, maybe. But I don't even know what's
low.
Okay, not there.
Yep. A little bit, but I mean, that was because he kind of just stopped there. I mean, that's a good punch for that.
Oh,
Oh, you were lucky he doesn't know how to do combos. The mix-ups. Oh no. That's pretty good. It is 50-50. Oh god, no.
Oh no. Wait,
yeah, yes. That worked out better than expected, actually. Yeah. I doubt he can fly up. Shit. I'm gonna watch that. It's 15, but only if you block it close up. I mean, there's no real reason to duck him. I mean, at the end of the round, it's... the body's pretty good in this game.
New challenge. Ready for the next battle. Round one. Fight. KO. Round two. Fight.
The waiting. Yeah. All right, not with that little health. Then you could just do that.
Yeah. I just throw more. stick to what I know.
Yeah, it's up to you.
No Williams. Get ready for the next battle. Round one. Fight!
You are so dead, yes. Well, you can't lodge it, but you're dead. If you didn't drop it. Yeah, it's everyone's best character. Oh no. Nice. What the fuck? Lucky, lucky. Oh. Yes. Watch out. Yeah, that's good. That's good. He's scared of up 4-3 now. Oh, bitch. That's a sick ass long range with him. This is bad, because he gets a full combo on Lars. But he dropped it. See if he can get it. Very nice, very nice. I don't suggest that. There, you got your mix of happy as fuck. Yeah.
Round four. Fight.
Well, he has a lot of range, but as a trade-off, he can't really move, so everything you do hits him too. His movement's probably worse than Kuma's.
New challenge.
What? Mashing is the key against Ogre. It's just you have to outmash him. Yes. Oh, you press circle. You have to outmash him. It's really character specific. It's not by like character size. So it just depends. Like you can't do it against Nina, but you can do it against Lars and Bob and Jin and others.
Get ready for the next battle.
I guess so. Yeah, I'm not. There's nothing to commentate. We picked the same characters as we did in the other game. Back to counter it. Solo combo. Against Hiroki. Breaks one pursuit throw. One pursuit throw. Waiting moon attempt with 60 seconds. Both of them kind of want to tag. Michael more so than William. And gets out safely and he's dead. Hunting Hawk, ugly, easy enter, yeah, a little too slow. Down 2, minus 4. On hit. Random waning moon. That wall is way too far away for that. Let's counter it. gets out of there, doesn't launch it. Could be the end of it. One throw. Now it's tied 1-1 in this casual game. No punish on the backflip. Divine Cannon. That should pretty much obstruct everything, yeah. For Kazuma's and Ogre. Ooh, look. You gotta stop using it for the long range whip punch. Oh, this is bad. Fight your way out, Lars. Oh, it's 12. Sweet Mangetti. Oh, capital. Michael never really plays his plus 2 after capital is blocked. Which is interesting. Choose not much. But Netsu Nina, we got 30 seconds left. About the same health as Lars. Let's counter it. This is a lot. No one can see. Windliger. Windliger, second hit whiff. All the gimmicks. 1-2-1-2 shoulder. Yeah. Oh, I need to move for 80. New challenger. And here we are at game 8 of this casual set.
You've been keeping count?
I don't know if it's 8. It's around there. No Williams. Over. Lars. I don't know. Lars is pretty good. I would not sub Lars for Anna.
Get ready for the next
especially against Jinpachi. Yeah, especially against Jinpachi. I think Lars is really good against Jinpachi.
Round one. Fight.
Like, Lars has too many quick mids for Jinpachi to do down forward 1 plus 2, for example. And on top of that, the up forward 3 thing from earlier. Up forward 3 has a really hard time launching. He has to decide up left Godfrey's. That's kind of a hard read to just block and do that. Okay. That was totally on purpose. Easy combo. 1-2. Yeah, I guess you can do whatever you want if it's gonna kill. I can't say shit. It's fun? What do you want me to say? What do you expect me to say, really? Saint is a good player. He wins. Surprise, surprise. Yeah, another thing, like Lars like naturally high crushes always like mid, all Jinpachi's mids and highs. Not all of them, but. Hell no. What the fuck? Yeah, Lars sidestepping things he shouldn't sidestep. Oh. He's not dead. Severely hurt, but not dead. Weird ass Oki. That was pretty good. It's minus 12 and you're not in crouch. Nice while staying forward. Oh, you're dead. Or you're severely hurt. Oh, you're dead. Yeah. Pretty much all of Ogre's launches do over 100. From all of his launches, I think. Except maybe up back 3. Well, that's a maybe. Well, this is over 100, because it's Nina. You can do 80. Nice clean 80. Two throw. Yeah, he's on to you. That's not so good. Oki's kind of annoying after though. You don't want to do that though. That beats virtually nothing. Yes. Haunting Hawk.
You get ready for the next battle.
It's hard to outmatch Ogre. It's because it's... I don't like it anyway. But it's good. It's really good against him. It really is. It's just you have to outmatch him. He can mash back. That's the problem. Yeah, see? Look at that. He's almost dead. He gets bullied pretty easily. But in exchange, he has really high reward on some certain things. Counter to burn back to 2-2-2-2-2-2-2. Look at that! 8 seconds. That's cool. You have to watch out when you do Lars combos on Ogre, because he can fly out and like down back 2-1 and stuff. If you're just paying attention, you just replace down back 2-1 with Arc Blast. Whatever. Are you aware that there's something within the game called context? No? Not you. You're fine. Just keep on mashing versus Ogre. Yeah. There's further context within that. And how come I get shit for doing Snake Edge while he gets to do down back 2 with Donnie all day? Explain that. Not you. He did, but not in the context you're thinking of. I wanted to make a hard read on down 4 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 1. But he just did down 4 2. That's all that happened. That's all that happened with Saint anyway. There were 3 Snake Edge that matches. The first one I'll admit, I thought he was going to do down 4-2, and I wasn't even paying attention. Like, I was sure he was going to do down 4-2, he did down 4-1 instead, I wasn't really paying attention. Second one was, I thought he was just going to run into it. That was a dumb idea. The third one, for sure, I blocked down 4-2, and I wanted to make a hard read, because it's a higher reward than sub up to pay. It's obviously a hard read. The second one I didn't get killed for, because I knew against Gondry, he doesn't have very quick mid whiff punishers anyway, and Snake Edge is surprisingly quick on whiff. Course over back 3 is not the same move, it has different uses. I'm not saying Snake Edge is a good low, I'm not using it for a low. Yeah, that's pretty much what I said, Illmatic. Because, yeah, I wanted to make a hard read on downpour 2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1. And I was wrong in my hard read. But hindsight's 20-20. A lot of people are confused because a lot of people don't know how to read within context of the game. Which is kind of upsetting, actually. It's arguable whether or not AK is good, but we all know AK has a lot of heart and confidence, so we all know that much. No, you just need to learn how to mash against them, that's all.
Dude, I swear, Anna is better.
Get ready, Anna over Lars? Back. I don't know about that.
Well, I don't know the combo with Anna anyway.
No. Round one. I'm still trying to remember these. Fight! Get ready for the next. Well, Nita Lars has a lot of combos. It's, you can see me trying to launch, just like naturally ducking and launching. It's virtually impossible to guess. It's a five-way guess. 1, or 1-2, or 1-2-1, or 1-2-1-2, or 1-2-1-2-1. So, it's too hard. You can definitely see me try to do Wastang 1 with Brian, but Brian's Wastang 1 doesn't push hard over there. Perhaps if I was Bob, Spanish upper would be fine. Of course you can do things like low jab to punish down forward 2 and also option select to crush highs for the down forward 2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1. But I wanted to make a hard read. With higher risk comes higher reward, right? Trying to tell me to do up forward 4 after ducking Ganyu's jabs from down forward 2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1? How much time do you really think you have? Not much. Definitely not much. At all. I would say it's virtually impossible. It's virtually impossible to get over heal from reading jabs after down 4-2 and then 1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1. Like, people don't even understand the snake attack against MMT. It all is just crazy. And the lack of reading within context is very upsetting. I'm kind of disappointed in you guys. Yeah, that's next week. I'm probably gonna have to explain this next week. I'll probably be on the show. Yesterday I was playing Tekken with Bronson instead. I'd rather play Tekken than talk about Tekken. I think that's true of all of us. Of course, there are always safer options. It's just Snake Edge is the one with a higher reward. And that's what I was thinking at the time. You have to understand, you gotta let people play the way they want to play. With high risk comes high reward. And that's mostly just preference. I normally don't even really go for high risk things like that. Yeah, you know, the problem was people didn't even know what I was betting on. That's what I'm a little disappointed about. How people can't read within the context of me blocking down for 2 and crushing highs. Even though you could see me struggling earlier before the match, trying to Wasang launch the down 4-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1. The Snake Edge was basically me giving up on trying to Wasang launch the down 4-2-1-2-1-2-1. It's basically what it was. Alright, would you guys get the same shit to Saint for doing down back 2 with Ganryu? It's virtually the same move. Snake Edge just kinda has this sort of taboo attached to it, that's all. New challenge.
This is Street Fighter, right?
Get ready for the next battle.
You really gonna defend his usage of down back 2 by saying it's only minus 20 instead of Snake Edge's minus 20? Somewhere between 3 and 7. Forrest really likes to argue for the sake of arguing, I noticed that much. Horace needs to stop arguing for the sake of arguing. I know you get less than a delayed hop kick, but it's not much less. And some characters, for example, Ganryu, doesn't get a delayed hop kick. Even though he probably does get dodge canceled back to down 4-1. It's hard to answer that, Wayne. Because I didn't play other people that much. Not as much as I wanted to, and the level I did see, it's hard to judge from just that. Horace, you are so interesting. You think you understand it, huh? You think you understand why I did it? Because I wanted to crush the jabs after down 4-2? Totally did not just say that. Round 4. Fight. Uh, I didn't get to play at Green. I had to leave immediately because my flight was just booked that way. Which is funny because if I would have left like 2 or 3 hours later, I would have been able to visit Green at least for like a little bit. There are two groups on Sunday. There are two groups. One group that went to the airport and flew back home. I was in that group. And the second group was one that went back to the airport to catch a taxi or train to Green Arcade. I was not in that group. It's an option. Yeah, stuff is fine. What? Well, you have the option. You can duck throws too. Sometimes I just do it against Ogre just to teach him. You have to sometimes.
Get ready for the next.
You have to show him why they're low tier. Yeah, it's good against Ogre. I mean, oh, it's optional. It's subjective, but I recommend it. That's great because Ogre and Hitachi with Bronzu is like nothing like Marcus. It's funny, actually. Bronzu's Ogre and Hitachi is like nothing like Marcus. No, it's pretty typical. Bronzu's just kind of weird. Wayne, I probably disagree with both of that.
Round two.
Yo, Matic, it's funny because I was just doing the combos I always do, but it's just that I don't think Brian Dragunov gets as much exposure in terms of optimizing. Brian Dragunov is also a hard team to optimize, I think. I did like and I did not like the play. I did not like my play in the sense that, I don't know, just this feeling in the back of my head that I didn't play as well as I could have. But we kind of all have that feeling when we lose. So I'm not sure if it's that, necessarily. But I did like the way I was playing in terms of me making the decisions I wanted to make and having it be just that. Like, I meant to do Snake Edge. I definitely meant to do it. And I meant to do 99% of things I did, so. Can't complain about that. Yeah, I don't think Brian Dragunov is optimized very well. So people think I'm doing like flashy combos and stuff. I'm not. I just think it's the best combo to do. What red life dragon out combo is? I don't understand. Which combo are you referring to? I think I did like two of them. I did like Brian's boss standing one, tacked the dragon off, and then like bread and butter to the wall. That's pretty simple. And then there's the other one where it's been known for a while now. You can do soccer kick and then jet up or tag dragon off 3-1.
new challenger. Get ready for the next battle.
Oh, there is that combo. That's Illmatic. That's the combo I do from Brian's Ford 4-1 if I want to TA and end up with Dragon off on point. That's when I do that combo. That's not a red life combo, obviously, but that's if I want to end a Ford 4-1 combo with a TA and ending up with Dragon off. Because that's the way I think about combos and stuff. The launcher itself, if I want a TA or not, who ends up at the end of the combo on points, and damage given up if I don't need to blast them all the way across the screen where the good three rods are. Like, you might have seen me do at the wall with Brian 4-4-1 to bound at the wall, and then drag out 4-4, and then Brian finishes with tag, not tag, he finishes with taunt, and then of course he'll go back forward to hit grounded. That's if I want to tag into Dragunov, but also TA at the wall. And it just looks really flashy. And I get a running mix-up. That's always cool. No, that is, hell no, that is not a mix-up. And it's not a mix-up for many reasons. Two primary ones being that back one is 7 frames faster, and the second reason being Snake Edge is just plain seeable. I don't know why I'm answering forced questions. They're very interesting questions. You really love arguing for the sake of arguing, don't you? Yeah, I just said that. QMH cooler, I just said that. Well, particularly, I said there's a 7 frame difference.
Yeah, but that's when you pay attention to. But you can see it. Yeah. After down at QMH, you see him. But you have to pay attention. He'll fly out of down 2-1, right?
Uh-huh.
And then you just arc blast. If you see it on, you can see it. Yeah, you just do it. And then it launches him fully. No, why would you do that when you arc blast to another full combo? No, you can't. No, they'll fly and then they'll land into the arc blast.
Yeah, I can't block.
Yeah, he can't block for a while.
Get ready for the next battle.
Yeah, you hold the color. And then you pay attention to when he flies there, but yeah.
Yeah, I'm not gonna do it.
Yeah, not a lot of ogres do it after that happens. They're like, oh shit. Yeah.
Wow.
What gives Korea the edge over the world? Probably their concentrated players. They all play at Green for the most part. For the most part. That and also they have a really strong history in Tekken. Tekken's kind of in their blood by now. I haven't played Miguel Huang in forever. But I could probably remember combos. It's a pretty simple team. Wayne, you can get combo from Dragon Off Down Back 2. If you're slightly to the left and you do down to as late as possible. That's how you get a combo. That's how you get while standing four afterwards and then forward one. As long as you're to the left slightly, you can actually see it. By the time you hit down two and while standing four, you can kind of like check if they're two, if they're the right distance. It's really hard to describe, but I think it's pretty cool. It also makes it so that I think Dragon Off might be better on 2P. For that reason, and also I like down two on hit. For people that don't know how to size up fuzzy, down two on hit, and then while staying two goes the way that the only way they can size it. I think I remember that down back 3 combo too on Saint, where I airsed out and then like I did like step kick and then jab. Jab was the wall carry. I didn't really plan further ahead. That looked really ugly. I don't like that. What'd you do?
Always, yeah, of course, whatever. All you ogres, all the same, throw out while staying twos. This isn't tag one anymore. No werewolves. Ogre. Jinpachi Mishima. Well, with while staying two, yeah. It really isn't that history between tag one battle. Ogre and now. It's not as good as it used to be, but you do as you please.
Can Leo break 90 with down 4-2 with any partner? I'm not sure about that. That would be really tough if anything. Round 2. Fight. How was that interview with Nico? Well, you can check it out on Flying Wonky. He uploaded the Nico stream of Global. I just gave some generic answers like I always do. I'm not the type to get interviewed. Fight. Way to be as vague as possible, Pat. Yeah, it might not be possible, practically speaking, it might not be possible to get down for two from Leo and expect 90 or over.
You win.
Yeah.
New challenge.
You can't do anything. Learning about Ogre Jinpachi.
Get ready for the next battle.
Yeah, it's surprising. It feels dangerous. That's what I like about it. Fight. Yeah, Ogre's really dumb. He might be shitty, but he's dumb. High risk, high reward, but high reward is still high reward. We talk about ogres, minus 20. You can, might as well, yeah. Yeah, I don't think you want divine cannon. I think reverse ivory cannon is better overall. Oh. That was a terrible crash. Yeah, you have to be careful. Stupid old man. Was that a throw? Was that a throw or no? You tried to throw when he did down back 1-2? Was that counter it?
No Williams.
Lost. Interesting. 90 with P-Jack. But that means you have to play P-Jack.
Get ready for the next too close.
Where are your glasses at?
It's in my car.
You never wear your glasses anyway.
Round one. Fight!
Ignore you for what? You didn't say anything. You want me to address everything you type? I'm not gonna do that. You want me to talk about you talking about debugger and going by sound? Well, if you can, that's great for you. What do you want me to say about that? Oh.
It just looks a lot worse than it actually does damage. Oh, what a waste. Yeah, Alvin, you didn't mean to do that. As far as I know, to get the quarterback 2-1, it's not character specific. However, there is a 6-frame gap, and that usually means they could tag in between. I know you could tag in between that. It's just within context, they wouldn't tag there, obviously. They get clocked by the one anyway. I don't know what to tell you then, to be honest. You could settle for back three SE3 instead. Back three SE3 is pretty much foolproof on the back. They can't even turn around if they wanted to. But I suppose that's his preference. If you're tired of forward back two whipping after back four, then you can stick with back three SC3 instead.
I don't know if you want to play
the... It's just you have to be prepared to, you know, do a combo with feet away, face up feet away, because they can't turn around unless they can't turn around if they wanted to. To be honest, I tried it out myself. Like, it's a real combo. Yeah, I think, no, don't get me wrong, I think you can turn around by, like, mashing and stuff, but I mean, you can't turn around by holding back or down back or tagging or anything. You can't turn around normally. You could turn around by mashing, but you obviously wouldn't want to turn around anyway. Man, that reminds me, I haven't gotten the Brian Infinite on someone forever. When an opponent's facing the wall, and then you land back forward to their back, it's pretty much an infinite until they mash. And then that's when I do Jet Upper, and by the time they realize that, they are probably dead. Yeah, see, Pat's not gonna quit Tekken forever. I told you that a long time ago. One way or another, he's not gonna quit Tekken forever. I told you that much. Palsy wants to play. It's an infinite until they mash, and once they mash, by then they are probably dead.
Every time you say that, you always laugh. It does sound funny, I don't know why.
Which is funny considering your playstyle.
That and Jimmy just talking.
Get ready for the next battle.
So, if... Oh, no, no thank you. If the opponent is facing the wall, and then you're, I guess, point blank? I don't know. I mean, enough to land back forward to work, like, back forward in the back of the head, and then you just keep doing it over and over. They can't turn around by holding back. They can't turn around by holding down back. They can't tag, obviously. They pretty much have to, ideally, throw to turn around. Because if they mash any other button, it's going to counter it. It's going to do more damage. And if they mash like an attack instead of a throw, I'll get explosions, which makes it easier for me to confirm that they turn around and then I'll get upper. And by then, they're done. Yeah, that's an old thing. That's been there since Tekken DR. Maybe DR too, I'm not sure. I don't know what you're referring to be honest. In terms of Huarong having something similar. No. Oh, you're dead. Yeah, even with that shitty combo, yeah, you're dead. I was really hoping that wouldn't have killed him.
I knew it was
coming. That was close. No Williams. Ogre. Jinpachi Mishima. Lars. What? So what? The Lars or? Isn't it supposed to stick to the one you've been picking?
Get ready for the
Isn't it supposed to stick to the one you've been picking? That's supposed to be how it works, I think. Like it remembers. Yeah, see, it remembers.
Round one. Fight!
That doesn't even make any sense. 3-3-4 and then right foot, right flamingo. Because then you do two, and then how do you get back to left flamingo? Like, where's the loop exactly? So you're bringing shit up just for the sake of bringing shit up? Obviously, if it's not guaranteed, it's not really worth talking about, is it? I don't understand. I don't understand why you would bring that up anyway. If it's not guaranteed, maybe not guaranteed. Who cares if it's maybe not guaranteed? Or who cares if it's not guaranteed? There's no reason to talk about it. Brian's back forward is guaranteed, that's for sure. It's just an issue of whether or not they turn around for the second back four. And if they turn around for the third back four. Or the fourth back four. It's funny how many back fours I've done. Okay. Oh, this Bopay is insane. He didn't do anything, but even if he did like the best combo, Bopay got sick. Oh, hey, ready. You don't want this to debuff. Didn't I tell you? Because I tried to... No, I told you. I bribed him with Korean cigarettes and then he came. I told you that. And that's what happened. That's what happened. I told you that yesterday. Or yesterday or like Monday. Maybe yesterday.
You ready for the next battle.
How to play this guy? I want to play more Mike.
Is he really wrong?
No, I'm sorry.
Try showing me a good time.
Round one. Fight! New challenger!
Yeah, you always do that now.
Well, I told you guys.
Get ready for the next battle.
Oh man, I'm too tired to play Paul. You can't talk all this shit when he wins around.
Yeah. That's the worst thing about playing Paul. You can't.
That's why he was resting. That's why he was resting in his grave.
That's why I hate most of them, you can't lose a single one.
I'm like, what are you kidding? There was lag in that. And I know for a fact that if I won that one, you
still It's funny because if you see him offline, he'll apologize and send me the
I don't know why I'm not.
just start lagging out, right?
Fight!
fight! New challenge.
Get some humping shit. Some more humping shit. All right, guys.
No Wilson.
No.
Lars. Get ready for the next battle.
Fuck this shit. Getting my ass beat right now. I'm talking. I'm commentating my own match right now. All right, Paul, beat up your Kuni. This might be better. I can't hear your voice now. Stay down there. Stay down there. Fuck.
Round two. Fight.
Alright, Paul, I'm gonna fuck you up this round. Oh, I was jumping. Alright, I'm gonna run this shit back right now. You're dead.
What were you thinking? Why'd you like jump up like that?
What was I thinking? You're right. Oh my god, well, I was thinking too hard.
Yeah.
One game at a time, Joe. One game at a time.
You're lucky I'm weak
right now,
battle.
Paul.
What? Think of what the biggest scrub would do, and imagine me doing that.
Oh man. Oh, it's one in the same, man. Alright. I gotta beat you, Paul. I don't think I've ever lost two straight to you. Oh man.
Round two. Fight.
We'll see.
Hey.
Oh, thanks! Oh, thanks again! You gotta step up your game if you wanna beat me 3. Oh, I don't know what happened there. Fight. Can't do it! Can't do it, can you, bro? I'm not good right now. But good enough to stop your 3-game win streak, or your 2-game win streak. You'll never get 3 on me. Never get 3 consecutively. Oh no, man. I don't remember.
Get ready for the next battle.
Next time? Why not this time? Oh, next time. That's what you meant. Okay. Alright. I'll tell you what, I'll pose for that when it happens. My guy. Jimmy, I'm up. Here, Jimmy. Alright. You pause ass right now. Yeah.
You can't break it.
Round three.
I'm 2 for 2. I'm not sure if he's guessing like with the right buttons. Oh shit. What the fuck is this? What a fag. Alright, fuck you. Risky with those chainsaws! Fuck this shit. Who the fuck is watching right now? Mike. Alright, Paul. You're going down. You're going down.
Get ready for the next battle.
What? I'm gonna fuck him up, Joe. Fuck his ass up. There's no more viewers anymore. Oh my god, what a scrub. Yeah. can't believe you won a tournament. Oh, that's right, there's only like 8 entrants. More than you. Fucked his ass up, Joe. You should be ashamed of yourself. I've been gone for like months. You win a tournament, you come back, you can't even beat me.
Get ready for the next battle.
Sucks, huh, Jimmy?
Round one.
Oh, thanks. That was a perfect amount of health. Oh, you did. No! Yes! Fuck his ass up again.
New challenge!
I'm gonna make it three. We'll see. Oh, Paul says he's gonna rage quit. Is this what you do online?
Get ready for the next battle.
Paul doesn't even know how to lose. Doesn't know how to rage quit.
Round one.
You got three right now, Paul. I was gonna rage quit. Ass move right there. Oh my god. Alright.
Final round. Fight.
Easy!
You win! What the
shit?
Get ready for the next challenge! No wins. Loss. Get ready for the next battle. Round one. Fight.
Yeah! Yeah!
KO. The new challenger. Kunimitsu. Alisa. Get ready for the next battle. Round one. Fight! Get ready for the next battle. Round one. Fight! Round two. Fight! Come on.
3. Fight!
Ready for the next battle. Round 1. Fight! Round 2.
Fight!
challenger. Kunimitsu. Arisa. Get ready for the next battle. Round one. Fight! Get ready for the next battle. Round one. Fight! Ha! 3. Fight! Round 4. Fight!
Alright, we're out of here, guys. Thanks for watching Iron Fist Friday. We'll tune in again 2 weeks from now when we do Iron Fist Friday again. Next week, we'll be doing Versus, which is Street Fighter 4 and Marvel King of Fighters. And maybe even some Street Fighter 3 4th Strike. Maybe. We'll see. But yeah, there's the information if you want to follow us. Facebook, YouTube, Twitter. All that good stuff. We're here at Golfland and Milpitas, 1199 Jacqueline Road. Subscribe, follow, all the good stuff. See you guys later. Peace.